that's cool with me, baby. Like, if you want to do that, that's fine. And I was like, no, you motherfucker, you're going to try set me up for like a little funny moment where I'm going to go, so what, are you single? And she's going to come back and make me look like a dick. I was like,
like you're asking her out.
Get them in off playing a bit of Lego, play a bit of Xbox. No, they came over to fuck, didn't they? That's it.
Yeah. She's like, how are you feeling? We were like, to be fair, we just want you to fuck off right now because we want to go back upstairs. Action.
How do you make them carrots?
The carrots that we had for dinner.
What do you cook them in?
You're so obsessed with them, aren't you? I always say it's a secret recipe, but it is literally...
Too good, B.
Honey.
Too good. That's it.
The honey roasted carrots, that's all they are.
That's all I needed to know. That's
no,
all you have to say.
Because
like,
now
honey...
you can kill me off and you can still make your honey roasted carrots.
Let's do it. Guys, welcome back to the SwingHub Podcast. I'm Gage.
I'm Olivia.
And today we are talking about our episode of Sex Actually on Channel 4 that's just aired.
So we are on Sex Actually Season 2 on Channel 4. And if you haven't seen it, it is on Channel 4 and it is also on that All 4 catch up.
So that's Season 2, Episode 2.
Season 2, Episode 2. But please don't watch it. It's cringy.
The feedback we got from it was really, really good. But yeah, watching it back was extremely cringy in that sense.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Some of that lighting did me dirty, I'm not going to lie.
And some of the angles.
Why did
really
they film underneath
like,
and like get all your double chin?
And like prop really, really close to my face as well.
I know.
And I've noticed I laugh a lot, which I need to stop doing because I'm an ugly laugher.
You're not only an ugly crier, but you're an ugly laugher.
So every time I laugh now on the podcast, not only am I back to hiding the double chin, and now I'm laughing, I have to like hide my face.
Do you know what I found out from that TV show?
What?
I always go, when I'm agreeing with you, I always go, yeah, yeah.
Really like monotone as
very
well,
very monotone and very like, yeah, yeah. I'm just agreeing with you. I'm like listening.
Go, yeah, I agree.
I agree.
Totally agree.
Screw you.
But yeah, we've got an exciting episode because today we are going to do a little giveaway. Mm-hmm. So we have got a little SwingHub bundle of merch. So for one lucky winner, what have they got to do? There's a little Gage is showing for all the audio listeners. Gage is showing
SwingHub
t-shirt and everybody seems to want one.
Yeah, everybody seems to want a t-shirt. Don't ask me why.
For some reason.
Some reason. I don't know why. We've got loads. We've got loads in the cupboard, haven't we? That's it. I don't know why everyone wants it.
I saw people wearing them and they rocked them and they look pretty hot in them.
Yeah, absolutely. So if you want a chance to win the SwingHub merch bundle, all you have to do is subscribe to the YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. Leave us a nice positive comment or some constructive criticism and we will pick out next week's winner on the next podcast.
And we've even got a little bobble hat. Let me try it on. Okay.
Do you know what I hate about you? Is no matter what hat you wear, you always rock it.
I feel like
we was in Cancun.
It's so big this one.
No, we was in Cancun and she put on a sombrero. Sombrero. And you still rocked it. And I put it on. I'm not like
can't see what I look like. That's the only problem.
Yeah. You look terrible. Take it off. I'm joking. You look all right, actually, because you rock every hat.
I feel like I'm a bit like a mismatched kind of
looks like you do like LSD on a weekend or something like that. You got like hippie vibe going on.
Proper like.
Yeah, I just live for the waves, dude. And, you know, I was like walking on the beach.
Stop making me laugh. I can't laugh.
Ugly laugher.
Right, I'm going to have to take this off. Because it's really
Let me put it back because somebody will probably want to buy that and then it'll have a bit of your hair in
I'm
it and they'll freak clone you.
Keep that one. You can have a fresh one if you want.
Yeah, there's some guy out there going, can I have that? Oh, that's your one. Because if there's got a bit of hair in there, I'm going to clone her. I'm keeping in a closet.
Do a DNA test.
Shag it, yeah. Let's talk about sex, actually.
Have you got a funny story, though, first to share it?
I have. I forgot the funny story. No, so we reached out to our group chat that's on Discord of their stories and kind of what funny stories, if it were funny, upsetting, if it were just like a heartwarming moment. And I wasn't ever expecting this. Okay. Okay. So these swingers on the very first meet said they drove from Sheffield down to Mansfield on a school night to this couple's house. This guy opens the door and he only has half an head. He neglected to tell us that he had a brain tumor and half his skull was missing. No wonder he was facing one way in all the pics.
And they didn't know. Like, they didn't know. No. So what? They opened the door and
the guy had half a head.
And not declared it.
And not declared it. I finally declared I got half a head. No, it just, well, she said that he had.
It took his pictures from the other side and didn't let
it was
know.
Facing one way in all his pictures. Right. So, and he just didn't tell him. So I kind of like was, I was a bit curious then. I was like, how did you get on with a guy with half a head? And what she said is that they were too naive to walk away from it, but it was the first time meeting anyone. So they went through with the whole thing and they had like loads of chats and about his experience and stuff, but they do regret the wish that they'd done things a bit more differently.
What would you have actually done in that situation? Because I know what I'd have like wanted to do in that situation, because I'm like, I'd find this really like awkward, and I'd be.
Well, first of all, the guy with half a head should be a little bit, I won't say ashamed of himself, but kind of, he should have told them, look, just let you know, I've got half my skull missing and I've got a big dip in my head.
But it's more the fact that he's tried to hide it by not taking pictures fully of himself.
But it probably were just always facing west when he was taking a photo. That's it, just to get the. But I'd be a bit curious. Yeah. If somebody sent me some like face pictures and we were just facing one way constantly, I'd be like, bro, turn around. Like, what's on the other side? What are you hiding?
So they went through with it. Did they go full way? Like, or was it just a social?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm going to have to
find out the remainder of this gossip.
I'm going to message them back and get the rest of the gossip on.
But actually, what would like our listeners be, like do? I'd love to know what people would do if they were in that situation.
It's
would
easy.
You head in and go for a drink and carry on and go all the way? Or would you be like, what the, and walk straight off? Because
it's easy to be a keyboard warrior and go, oh, I'd do this and I'd do that and I'd walk away, or I'd slap him one because, you know, it's just not right because he didn't, as you say, declare it. He has to fill in a form, like a declarations form or something. But, you know, at the time, you're probably like, oh my God, you don't want to hurt the guy's feelings, right? No. You know, she must have found him attractive in some form of way to kind of get going, but I don't know.
Oh, that was an unexpected story.
That kind of threw me off.
I think this is good, this little story time.
Yeah, I think we should make it into a segment every podcast.
So it's going to be everybody has to send in the little stories, whether they want to send them to me, to you, to the SwingHub app.
Yeah, absolutely. Or you can leave them in the YouTube comments. And we'll pick one really good one out and we'll feature it on the podcast. That sounds like a plan, doesn't it?
Yeah. I like that idea.
DM us on Instagram, send it through there, YouTube.
Yeah, whatever. DM us on Instagram, at least it'd be anonymous. Private. No, then it'd be private. Then nobody can find out until we've actually spoken about the story. Because if it's open and people can see it, then people can see the story before we do the podcast.
Yeah. That's true. Should we talk about sex, actually?
Yeah, after our little warm-up story time.
half a head.
So we got approached on my Instagram, wasn't it, by Mindhouse Productions, which is Louis Theroux's
production? Louis Theroux's company, yeah.
Company, yeah, production company. And they messaged us on Instagram, basically, and was like, we're doing this documentary. Would you fancy, coming on and doing the documentary with us? And we was like, yeah, that sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, but you know what? It's, I don't think, did it actually come from the Mindhouse Instagram or one of them little dodgy ones? Because only these, like, the create burner Instagram profiles, don't these TV companies, and message you. And we've gone, wait a minute, is this right? And you kind of go along with it and it actually turns out to be the real deal.
I can't remember.
When did the messages?
Gosh, it was last summer. Like, I want to say like May, June last year. That the message does.
Yeah, so then they wanted to set up a Zoom call just to make sure like we were right to like be on the TV show. Mm-hmm. And we had a Zoom call with a guy called Pete. He was a director. And was it Val?
Barnaby on the Zoom call.
Were it Barnaby?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we kind of had a Zoom call, had a chat. And there was like, guys, you know, we just want to come up and visit you. And we was like, okay, if you want to come up and have a chat, you're more than welcome to. And they came up, didn't they? We had Team Biscuits outside.
Yeah. And just basically, they then told us what they wanted out of us, basically, and what they're looking for, and it all seemed really like we were up for it, weren't we? And
yeah,
everything that they were saying to us, it sounded a bit of us that we wanted to direct the lifestyle in like a really positive light, and everything that Pete has directed and produced has been really sex positive and really open and not seedy or negative.
Because we've never actually watched sex actually before until they got in contact with us. So we was like, oh, we'll give it a watch. Mm-hmm. And we liked how Alice was more curious about sex than just forming a full opinion. She was asking a lot of questions and she didn't like, she was going, oh my God, that's disgusting. Or like, oh, I'm really into this. It was just a nice mutual like thing that she was doing, just being curious in that sense. So it was like, yeah, let's do it. So we kind of set a date for filming, but amongst that, another TV show got in touch as well, didn't they?
Yeah.
So we was like, oh, amazing. This is actually going to be quite sick. We're going to be on this. We're going to be on Sex, actually, with Alice Levine. But then we're going to be on this TV show, which we knew is 10 times bigger than what Sex actually is. Mm-hmm. But the bigger TV show kind of said, you need to be here for this date. And it ran across the dates that we was meant to be filming for Sex, actually. Mm-hmm. Can you remember when I told him about the dates?
Yeah, and because obviously it was a conflict of interest. It's on the same channel, and he was like, "He was like, look, I don't think we're going to be able to do it because we've been given this other opportunity, and it's a bigger opportunity. We're just going to have to not do the documentary with you guys." And he was like, "Well, was he like Gage?
Well, let me just backtrack a little bit because I sent him a WhatsApp explaining what had happened, and then he called me up straight away and he went on this massive sales pitch. This was Pete, the director, absolutely amazing guy. And he was going, you know, with us, you'll get a full hour episode of us. You can really tell your story. You know, you can explain everything you do with VistaWife, with any other businesses you've got going on. And it's all about you. And we kind of like, I went back to you and I was like, oh, Liv, they're actually going to give us like a full hour episode. And it really sold me on it. And you was like, listen, this other program is 10 times bigger. We're not going to go into details of what it is, but
I really wanted to do the other one as
you
well.
Wanted like, to
the opportunities there and the things that will come out of that maybe would be bigger and better than just doing the filming with Pete and Alice.
Yeah. So then he called me up and I said, look, we're going to have to go with this other TV show. And he said, "Oh my God, Gage, I can't believe it." He's like, "I'm absolutely devastated. You know, I thought we had this thing going and, you know, this program's going to be absolutely amazing. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to do this." And I was like, "Pete, I'm sorry, but this is just our decision. We're just going to have to like roll with it." He went, "Screw it. Let's film it anyway. And if Channel 4 don't put it out, then they don't put it out." But he goes, "I really want to film you guys." So I was like, "That's cool with me, baby. Like, if you want to do that, that's fine."
Yeah, so we stuck to our guns and got the best of both worlds. But I think, like, so when the day actually came to filming, we met them all at the train station, wasn't there? Because the plan was to meet at the train station. Alice would come in at our car and we would play our little game of hot or not.
Oh, yeah.
But they didn't show that, did they?
No. Oh, so hot or not, for everybody listening, if you don't know what it is, me and Olivia, when we go on little journeys, if we're in the car, we play this game called Hot or Not. And what it is, when you're driving in one direction and then you see somebody walking in the same direction, you see the back of them, and we have to say hot or not if they're the caliber of somebody that we'd play with. And you've only got a couple of seconds and you got to judge it from the back of the person. So you kind of go hot, no, no, yeah, no, hot, yeah, hot, hot, hot. And then you kind of go, no. And then sometimes we've been quite surprised that we're like, nah, he's got a mullet. Oh, oh. That's you saying it, not me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I might grow a mullet.
Yeah. So we decided to do that. So we drove around, didn't we? Round Sleaford and back to our house. And then it was really weird because she then had to sit in the car and she wasn't allowed to come any further until they'd set the house up. Do you remember?
Yeah.
And because, like, I think because she's, it's like a documentary series and she wants to ask you all these questions, but she wants to ask them the first time of asking them. So they'd separated us for a good half an hour, even though she'd just been in the car and we'd got chit-chatting and got on really well. We'd got then separated once we got to the house to just set everything up and make sure all the mics were up and where we were going to film and things like that. So, and then she came in and basically we'd started making a cup of tea and she just straight in started asking the questions and filming straight away. And we were like, "Oh, I'm not prepared for this."
No, to be fair, giving, like, I think the way Alice works, she must be great at like listening, but having that next question lined up straight away, because there were no awkward silences. It was, we'd finish what we were saying and then she'd be like, bam, question.
She already had a question in the back of her head, didn't she?
Yeah,
she
absolutely.
She wanted to ask the next one, and you could see like the clogs working, couldn't you? Which was amazing. But she is, like you said, she was the most nicest, friendliest, open, I think, person to be like delving into like everybody's lives and things like that.
Well, I said to Pete on the phone before she got here, like the day before, I was like, just a quick question, just out of curiosity. I was like, is Alice single, or is she like got a boyfriend? Is she gay? Is she married? And then Pete was like, "Well, you're gonna have to ask her when you see her, aren't you?" And I was like, "No, you motherfucker! You're gonna try set me up for like a little funny moment where I'm gonna go, so what, are you single?" And she's gonna come back and make me look like a dick. I was like,
"Like you're asking her out."
Like I'm asking. I was like, "Pete, I'll fucking Google it. All right, it was just a curiosity question. Yeah. So she's gonna come to my house. I'm gonna try it on with her."
Although I know you would.
Hey, I'm just saying, if she wanted to, I'm not saying no.
But then the plan was to then invite another couple for a little afternoon play date, wasn't it?
Can we not say play date?
You don't like play date?
No, it's a bit too like, we'll get the Lego out.
Get the Monopoly.
Get the Monopoly and a bit of Lego, play a bit of Xbox. No, they came over to fuck, didn't they? That's it.
Yeah. So it was one of our friends that had agreed to come over, hadn't they, and be filmed while doing the business upstairs.
Yeah. So it was just, we were talking about it and Alice was like, so how's it all go beforehand? Like, what do? Do you kind of just get in there and you kind of just swap partners straight away? And I was like, nah, me and Steve, like we talk about, like we both play golf. So we'll probably bring up some golf chat and whatnot. And,
she was like, what, you'll talk about golf and then you'll go upstairs and have sex? Okay.
Yeah, that's it pretty much. And they came up and we did exactly that. We spoke about golf, sat outside, had a drink, went upstairs. But the experience with sleeping with them wasn't the full experience, was it?
No, because we'd played with these guys before and obviously like we had the best time ever then. But because everybody was in the house and you knew that Alice was downstairs making herself at home, having a cup of tea, and that Barnaby was also there like writing the transcript, and then Pete was then recording it on this massive camera thing. He had a massive camera with a hoist.
Yeah, like a little bagpipe. So it's to hold the weight of the camera. So it's like a bagpipe and it has like a big metal bar going down your spine over the top of your head. And then it's got a wire and it attaches to the camera. So you could just like lift it up and just kind of move it around easy.
So it's not the most discreet thing in the world. And he was like, don't worry, I won't disturb you while you head upstairs. And then we were getting all like down to business and we were basically like fucking. And then you caught Pete on the landing, didn't you? Because the door was wide open and he was stood on the landing with this massive camera. Oh. And you were like,
bro, I flopped. And she was like, you're all right. And I was like, I just don't feel too good. But it was just like, because Pete was there. And it's all good. Like, if we film like content for OnlyFans, is that, yeah, we might put a camera up and we just forget about it and have a blast. But when you've got when you've got somebody there with a massive proper TV camera, it puts you off a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, I caught him like a few times in the corner of my eye and I was like, oh, I forgot about you there. And then I was like, oh shit, they're downstairs as well. Alice is in my living room downstairs. So I think like I wouldn't say it was awkward, but it just wasn't. I feel like we all couldn't relax as much as and enjoy it as much.
Because subconsciously as well, I was thinking, oh, what is Alice saying downstairs? Is she going to be like, oh, actually, it sounds like they're having a really good time? Or would it be, you know, I didn't want to be up there for an hour and a half and then they're knocking on the door going, oh, guys, you nearly finished.
Imagine? Because last time, I'll tell you a little story. Last time we played with these guys, we did our first ever separate room swap because we were in the same hotel. We had rooms like quite next to each other. It was literally like two rooms and our room, wasn't it? So it was a room two doors down. So it was like, they was like, how do you feel about a separate room swap? And we were like, oh, it's something that we've actually never done. So we were both game for that, weren't we?
Yeah.
And then we was like, so how do we know when to come back and what do you want to do? And then we all thought, we were like, it's a really good idea. Shall we set a timer? How long did we set? Like an hour?
No, I think, was it like 45 minutes, I think.
45 minutes. And then, so we decided to set a timer for 45 minutes and then we headed off and separated. I went with the guy and you went with the girl, obviously. But me and the guy, who was like really conscious of the time. We were like, right, we've got like 10 minutes left. We need to finish up. Like, come on, we've had a good time. Like, let's finish up. And then we were like, finished. The time went off and we're like, right, let's go back to them and see like how they're getting on. And obviously they should be finished because they've got the little 45 minute timer. Oh no. We knocked on the door and was like, have you finished? And she was like, no, we haven't.
Well, she answered the door and she was like, oh, we've not even finished yet. And you came in and she was like, we need more time. And
so can you imagine that if we'd have been like an hour, 2 hours later and Alice is still sat on our sofa, like pondering life.
And to be fair, I don't think it was the most exuberating thing for her because obviously from season one and now watching what happened on season two, ours wasn't as like...
I felt ours was really tame.
Did you notice that we didn't get much airtime on the episode? Mm-hmm. Do you know why that is? If you look at anything media, is they look for the stupidity in something or something you can laugh at or put a comment on and you go, oh my God, that's weird. I think they came over and because our lifestyle's not about that, they didn't really have anything to kind of put in there for what we did all day.
Yeah.
For them to go, we'll pull that in because it'll just stir loads of shit. Or we'll do that. Like this, we was like, this is what we do. And then afterwards we was like, we feel really connected right now. And we just want to like keep on loving each other. Yeah, and that's it.
I think like the showed that really nicely, like the connection afterwards. The one thing that you can't really explain, but I felt like we definitely showed it in the episode is the reconnection of the couple left after we'd had sex and obviously said our goodbyes and had a little chat at the door and they left and we went back into the living room and was like basically telling Alice, how are you feeling? And we were like, to be fair, we just want you to fuck off right now because we want to go back upstairs.
It was, and it was true, and I think they couldn't pull much from it to, you know, compared to that episode. Mm. You know, you look at like there were a woman about polyamory and she was talking about all the partners and then the extended partners and their partners, and she's like, people go, wait a minute, what the fuck? Yeah. Where for us, it was just a couple swap, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, there was no really like nitty gritty. There was no, I think like we was very normalized the swinging lifestyle, and I think we did it really well. And obviously, they couldn't get much out of it any more than they did, I suppose. Hmm. And I just think that the fact that it was funny that it kind of ended abruptly, did the filming after we'd come downstairs. She asked us a few more questions, didn't she, of how we felt and how we felt it went, and would you like to see them again? And what are we feeling right now? And that was then the way that we were acting and wanted to be together and how we are.
I don't think you were expecting it, was she?
She wasn't expecting it. She found it really like, oh, it's really nice to see that you just are in total love with each other even after you've done that together. Mm. But then, so that's basically how it ended, and she left, didn't she? And was like, right, okay, thanks for having us.
Done, and then kind of just, you know, they stuck around 5 minutes saying thank yous and then just left.
Yeah.
And then we didn't really, well, obviously they called us now and again, but it was just the, how are you doing? Because Channel 4 are really good with like mental health support as well.
The aftercare
is really good. So before they were saying, because with every TV show that you do, you have to speak to a psychiatrist. Mm-hmm. It's a psychiatrist, isn't it? Yeah. And, you know, they're saying, look, just basically checking how you are as people. And for us, like, there were no problems because we've got a social media platform anyway. So we're used to like all the negativity coming in. So we had no issues with that, but I think it's more for people that have never done TV before and just to warn them what it can have a negative impact.
Yeah, and the fact of maybe just make sure you've got a good support network around you, and if you need anything, they're always there to talk to. And even when the episode went out, like the episode went out on Monday and we got a phone call basically, how do we think it went? Do you guys need any support? Do you need to be referred to anyone to talk to? And it's just basically the aftercare of the whole experience of just making sure everybody's okay after everything's happened, really.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's overall a good positive experience.
Yeah, but if you haven't watched it, don't watch it.
It's not cringy.
It's so cringy. And everybody will be like, oh God.
Oh gosh.
But I really enjoyed it. And I enjoyed the whole experience. And it was something completely different for us to do. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We were actually gifted something from our guys who do our merchandise. So the SwingHub merchandise that you can win, the little bundle, they have gifted us something. And I have no idea what it was. I think they like wrapped it up.
They've wrapped it up. So for the podcast listeners, it's like a white envelope box with a nice little gold ribbon out of it. So big thank you to Sick Graphics, Sick in S-I-K-G-F-X, who are in partnership with SwingHub to create all our merch. So big shout out to them. Do you want to open it? Or shall I open it?
I don't know. You can open it.
Okay, here we go.
Ooh. So they've basically told us, it says open on a live stream or a podcast.
Yeah.
So exciting.
Okay, let's do it. I'll hold it up so we can see it. Yeah. Let's have a look. There's a note. It says, to Gage, Olivia and Bailey, what a pleasure it has been working with you so far. Onwards and upwards with the merch and the future endeavours. Love, Matty and Josh.
Oh, what have we got?
A business card. Not just a business card. It was a business card. Do you know what? I'm going to put that... Oh, my God. Before I do...
Oh, my God. I feel like he wanted you to open this and like...
And it's going
to
go everywhere. You're not going to get me today, Matty.
Yeah.
You're not getting me today... Oh, fuck you.
Surprise!
You
just done that.
Look at this.
Oh, that's cute. Is that for like the shelf?
It's for the shelf.
I like that. That's really cute.
Matty from Sick Graphics, S-I-K-G-F-X. That is, look at that.
A little swing hook.
Put that in the middle.
Where are we putting it? In front? Oh, are we blocked? In front of the Epcot wall? Can we see that big?
Beautiful.
Is that good?
Oh. We'll have to find its little home.
I love getting gifts.
You like getting gifts.
Made me a little bit emotional. Ooh. But yeah.
But yeah, so they were saying when we picked up all the merch the other day, it was like actually me and Josh have been listening to the podcasts while we've been doing all the printing and the boxing up. And I was like, really?
Yeah.
And like they've actually full on support us, and which is really nice. And
I'm gonna put this right here.
And we'll tag
all their socials and stuff.
All
like
their
that.
Socials and things on our
Right, hopefully they can see that in the camera.
Maybe not. Maybe you're in the way, but
maybe, who knows?
But yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, a little surprise gift to end the podcast.
I love it.
You like it?
I do love it. So to that end, guys, thank you very much for watching.
Thank you.
There you go. A little bit behind the scenes of Sex, actually.
Yeah, and what we got up to and all the little secrets and not much to tell, though, really. Like, secret-wise, I think it just went really well. And
yeah. And also, don't forget, you can win SwingHub merch right here on this podcast by simply following us on this YouTube channel, leaving a nice comment or some constructive criticism. And you could win a SwingHub bundle and that hat that you absolutely rock. There's loads of stuff that we'll send in a pack. If you're on Instagram, please follow us on Instagram at SwingHub app. And if you're on Twitter at SwingHub app, did you know we are on Apple Podcasts and Spotify too?
Yeah, and I think you can rate them on Apple Podcasts and Spotify as well, can't you?
Yeah.
So that always helps. Give it a rate. Tell the listeners what you think of it. And it like bumps it up as well for other users to see.
Yeah, so leave us a good feedback, baby, and we can grow and reach out to more people. Get more newbies in the lifestyle.
Whoop, whoop.
It's all good.
Right, we fist bumping it.
Fist bumping it, yeah.
It's my dumb boobs! No!
Tiger Lily moved to the city, she just turned 21. And then I said, here's my number, hit me up if you're needing anyone. And then I could be anyone.